Now today, I am Flix. We're going to bring you a critical story. A story about the Little Shop of Horrors. This movie was actually made on a bet, where somebody bet a small amount of money, that somebody could make a movie in a weekend. And they did. Then it became a big hit later. We're going to see a mixed version as we rewrite the endings here on I Am Flix.
Take something designed by nature and reprogram it to make it work for the body rather than against it.
You're talking about a virus?
Indeed, yes, in this case, the measles.
We gave her what we call ALZ-112, a gene therapy that allows the brain to create its own cells in order to repair itself. Iridensis, we call it the cure to Alzheimer's.
Movies show us lots of experiments gone wrong, but we have to recognize that in real life, these scientific experiments go wrong, maybe even more than in the movies. We have to recognize the incredible horrors that science has actually imposed. We like to look at the good news, but there are horrors that have been exposed by science. Different things that have happened. And one of the most incredible potentials is that of the GMOs, the genetically modified foods, for what will effect will it have on our culture and our society. We don't know enough to play God and to try to play with life itself. We just don't know enough.
It's alive.
20 years, Clinestra has sued more than 800 family farms over patent infringement. They've got the money and the muscle to win.
How do you patent life? I mean, honestly.
It's hard to wrap your head around, I know. But in the early 80s, the courts ruled living organisms that had been genetically altered were eligible for patent protection.
I mean, that's crazy.
Nature knows, and nature knows what to do, and we can't be messing it. Time is running out for us. If, as a human race, we think that we can basically use technology to solve the problems that technology has made. We have to have a better grip on being cautious and not let people put profit over people. We have to be able to get back to an idea of understanding and respect for nature, not respect for profit. And basically move very cautiously as we move, especially when we talk about things that can be consumed by the human body, that can do horrific damages and incredible potentials. And we have to recognize that every drug once credentialed by the FDA, at one time approved by the FDA, that many of these drugs, in fact, a vast quantity of these drugs, have been removed from the market. And basically, you people are the scientific experiment. You are the guinea pig, and you need to stop it before it dangerous happens.
I have an assignment for you. I want to give you some ideas, and then I'll alert you along the way to Google certain topics. Now, the topic is GMOs, genetically modified organisms. Start with that. Google GMO. Now, what I want you to notice is that you'll see the term GMO in terms of food, namely corn, soybeans, and the like. Now, when I first heard genetically modified organism, I thought, that's great, you know, like roses and hybrids and cross-pollination and the like. Stop. It gets more complicated. Imagine you're a big company like Dow or Monsanto or Lionel Media, and you create a strain of soybean or corn that bugs won't eat or that won't need herbicide or is immune to it. Google Roundup Ready Soybean. Do it. Soybeans naturally contain trypsin inhibitors, which protect them against bugs and pests. The only problem is weeds. Spray, say, Roundup or something like that, and you might kill the soybean along with the weeds. Enter the Roundup Ready Soybean, introduced in 1996. The soybean's protected from the herbicide. Now, Google that. Now, where it gets interesting is not in the actual GMOs themselves, but the politics involved in their distribution and their exclusivity. And something that's even more fascinating, biodiversity. Now let me stop right there. For purposes of this commentary, I want you to be aware of this. I want you to remember me and our time together now, and if you only say, oh yeah, GMOs, yeah, I heard something about that, good, then I will have succeeded. These are fascinating subjects that merge food and science and genetics, politics, biodiversity, globalist legislation, and a host of resultant issues. You will then branch off into food wars and groups of folks who are absolutely adamant about their disdain for anything GMO.
On the 23rd day of the month of September, in an early year of a decade not too long before our own, the human race suddenly encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. And this terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
Please, lady, don't! Put your clothes back on! It's Wink! Well, you can't do this to me! What if your husband were to walk in? I'm right here, Wink. I'm sorry. I love your show, but I've got to kill you both with this machine gun.
Let's take another look at what happened in the past, at our two star-crossed lovers and how they lost control of the situation. What happened the last time the plan came?
Lip off your head, wash of your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, with the lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Simon is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend. Suddenly Simon standing beside you, sweet understanding. Say more to your
nobody
friend.
Ever treated me kindly. Mama left early, daddy was poor. I'm me the man and I follow him blindly. He snap his finger to me and I'm say sure. Suddenly Simon standing beside me. He don't give me orders, he don't come sad. Suddenly Simon is standing beside me with sweet understanding. Say more's my
tell
friend.
Me this feeling lasts till forever. Tell me the bad times circling washed away. Please understand that it's still straight and frightening. For losers like you being it's so hard to stay. Suddenly Seymour, if you will find me. Suddenly Seymour, he showed me I can learn how to be more. The girl that inside you with sweet understanding, with sweet understanding, with sweet understanding.
I'm just a mean green mother from outer space. and it looks like you've been had.
I'm just a mean green mother from outer space, and I'm bad.
I'm just a mean green mother from outer space, so get off my back, get off my face, cause I'm mean and green, and I am bad.
You don't know what you're messing with. You got no idea.
Save your skin, boy. You want to save your hide? You want to see tomorrow? Better step aside.
And I am bad.
Take a tip, boy. Want some good advice? You better take it easy, cause you're walking on thin ice.
Space and I'm back.
alien planet with an appetite for human flesh has come to the Earth, has fooled people, and created terror and horror. Truly is danger in genetically modified organisms. You never know how nature will react and what will happen to the environment in long-term generations ahead. Man does not know enough to interfere with nature. We must ever be on guard. We must always watch and check and test and validate and always beware. You never know where evil may lurk.
Subsequent to the events you have just witnessed, similar events in cities across America. Events which bore a striking resemblance to the ones you have just seen begin occurring. Subsequent to
and human beings all have a desire to be like everybody else. Humans can be so driven with the desire to conform and to be like everybody else. So they all buy a plant. Everybody wants to be like everybody else. Everybody wants to have a plant. Nobody wants to be the last one to buy. But this evil plant has something else. This evil plant starts to take over. Is it too late? Has this evil plant gone too far? Is it too late? Has it spread too far? But it seems like it's too late. Is it too late? Has this evil gone so far, spread it so far? Can it be stopped? Or is it too late? Thank you. With no predators, could this plant take over? Is it possible? Though in the beginning of our story, it has. It seems like it's too late. Nothing can stop this evil. But the army gets involved, and they fight valiantly. And the army fights back. And they drive the evil back. And the army starts to get the upper hand. Now the plants are defeated. All is well, but can it happen again? Well, that's our story. Can it all happen again? Time has gone by, and the world has forgot the horrors of the GMO, because big money has made them forget. But there are certain times that we must also remember the dangers, and we must be able to confront these dangers of the GMO plants. Could it possibly be that these plants will come back at the little shop of GMO horrors?
The most terrifying period in the history of my beat began in a little run-down floor shop called Mushnick's.
Ah, good morning, Mrs. Shiva. How's things today?
Oh, the same as usual, Mr. Mushnick. My sister's nephew Stanley died in Little Rock, Arkansas.
Oh, what happened?
He got blown up. Who knows how?
That's nice. Well, you would like, maybe, as usual, some flowers for the funeral.
Should all acquaintances be forgot? And never brought to mind.
I thought possibly, because I always give to you all my funeral business, and maybe you should possibly give to me, A little cut rate.
Look on me, Mrs. Shiver. What am I, a philatelist? I sell on Skid Row nothing but cheap carnations. And I should give you a cut rate. I can't even afford water for the flowers. To my throat, I would be giving a cut.
I dreamt I dwelt in marble halls with vassals...
Get up from the back! Excuse me, Mrs. Shiver, that Seymour...
He's a nice boy.
Why don't you let him see?
What, see? Look, here I got a new customer, brand new in the yellow vest. I should let the cleanup boy, but I can't even afford chase him out right away. Flowers as fresh as the springtime, Mushniks. Hello. Oh, hello, Dr. Farb.
What can I do for you today?
Listen, Mushnik, I haven't got much time. Send me over 2 gladiolas and the fern.
Excellent. That's 2 dozen glads, 1 potted fern.
No, 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 Mushnik. 2 gladiolas and 1 fern.
You want I should put 2 gladiolas in the pot with the ferns?
No, 1 fern. 1 piece altogether, 3 pieces. I need it for my waiting room.
Yeah, thank you.
What?
A filling out.
Good, I'll drill a bigger hole.
You mean you want 2 crummy gladiolas and 1 crummy fern? What kind of a decoration is that?
Listen, it's my flower budget for the week, Mushnik. Who can be a dentist on Skid Row?
All right, excellent. I'll send Seymour right away.
Who am I to argue with science?
Make it snappy. Now you are going to get it. Oh, you are going to get it. Look.
Seymour Krellboin? Now, Mrs. Shiver, we were talking from the funeral flowers, but in the little...
funeral!
Did you call me Mr. Mushnik?
No. I was calling John D. Rockefeller for to make a loan on my Rolls Royce.
Sorry I said it.
Now look, Seymour. You take 2 gladiolas. You'll cut them nice and even. You'll take 1 fern. You'll wrap them in a package, and you'll take them to Dr. Farr. Right? Well, go already! Now, what can I do for you, sir?
My name is Burson Fudge.
Excellent. I am Gravis Mushnik.
Oh, that's a good one.
Now, who's going to get my roses?
I'll take care of you, Mrs. Shiver. Come right over here.
You would like maybe some orchids for a nice girl?
No, I think I'd like a couple of dozen carnations.
Carnations?
A person can't turn around these days that somebody shouldn't drop dead.
You've had more than your share of bad luck, Mrs. Shiver.
Bad luck, she calls it. You should have so many people kick off. You would have somebody fall on top of you, too.
What about the carnations?
You said you wanted some roses.
Yeah, for Stanley.
My carnations.
You should see what that Seymour is. Oh, here are your carnations. Wait, I'll wrap them for you.
No, that's all right. I'll leave them here.
Why not? Of course, what else? They are all right?
Well, I've had better.
Well, this is a small shop.
Oh, that's okay. You know, those big places, they're full of pretty flowers, expensive flowers. When you raise them for looks and smell, you're bound to lose some food value. I like to eat these little out-of-the-way places.
Ah! Such a thing, eating flowers.
Look, don't knock it until you try it, huh?
Look what happened.
This is what I was trying to tell you before. Look on him, everybody. Look at the quality of his work. I ask you, when I fire him, where is he going to get such another good job?
You mean I'm fired?
No, I'm electing you president from the United States. Yes, you are fired!
Gravis, you can't do that.
Who can't?
I didn't mean it.
You didn't mean it. You never mean it. You didn't mean it the time you put up the bouquet with the get well card in the funeral parlor and sent the black lilies to the old lady in the hospital. You didn't mean it. But this time, I, Gravis Mushnik, mean it!
He means it.
But gee, Mr. Mushnik, don't I always try to do what's right? And I'm crazy about flowers. I like flowers almost as much as Audrey does.
Excellent. You're fired.
Why don't you give him a chance to resurrect himself?
I give him a chance to quit.
I ain't gonna quit.
You're a brave boy. You're fired.
But that ain't fair, Mr. Mushnik. You know what I'm doing? I'm working on a special surprise plant just for you. I'm growing a plant like you ain't never seen before.
Excellent. I can't even sell the plants I got in my shop. Out, you!
Now, wait a minute. He's got a new kind of plant you ought to look at.
I don't look on flowers, Mr. Yellow Vest. I got ancestors in the flower business for 200 years, but I got one shop on Skid Row, one stinking shop. I don't even like flowers.
No, you don't understand what I mean. Look, I've eaten in flower shops all over the world, and I've noticed that the places that have the most weird and unusual plants do the best business.
See?
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 What is this, a tango? All right. Explain me more.
Well, I remember one place that had a whole wall covered with poison ivy. And people came from miles around to look at that wall, and they stayed to buy.
The owner got rich?
No. He scratched himself to death in an insane asylum.
Oh, that was my cousin Harry.
All right. All right. You go home and you get this fancy schmancy plant and you bring it back here. And if Mr. Yellow Vest Fouch says it's a draw, you still got a job. If he don't, out you go to Bodie, right?
Don't worry, you'll like it. You'll see.
This is Radio KSIK. You've been listening to Music for Old Invalids. Our next selection is entitled Sick Room Serenade.
Seymour, is that you?
Yeah, Ma.
Hey, here, look at my tongue.
But, Ma, I already seen your tongue.
Have you no sympathy for your poor mother? Laughing at her and mocking her illness, and she's got one foot in the grave?
Oh, I didn't mean it.
Oh, you never mean it. Oh, come on, look at my tongue.
A tongue's a tongue, Ma. They all look the same to me.
Oh. Did you stop at Dr. Mallard's and get the results of my tests?
Yeah, he said there's nothing wrong with you.
Oh, not Dr. Mallard. He's one doctor I thought would tell the truth.
He said you should be playing fullback for the Rams.
He wants me dead. I'll bet he's assistant coroner.
Well, I gotta go.
And I know I've got my goiters coming back. I can feel it every morning after breakfast.
Yeah, that's when you take those great... Oh!
What you got, a little surprise for me?
Open it up and see.
All right. Oh! Dr. Slurp Saddle's famous tonic. Wait here. To be taken internally or externally for pain and neuritis, neuralgia, headache. If hit by a truck, call your physician. Alcoholic contact, 98%. Oh, Seymour, you'll never know what this is gonna do for me. Oh, I can feel that surge of warm health going through me already.
Look, Ma, I gotta get my plant and hurry back to the shop.
You mean that lousy weed out in the kitchen?
Yeah, and if Mr. Mushnick doesn't like it, he's gonna fire me.
Apparently, my hearing is going out on me. I get the distinct impression that your job security depends on what Mushnick thinks of that thing.
Gee, it looks worse than it did this morning when I went to work. I wish I knew what to do with it.
Well, if you asked me, I'd pitch it out in the trash. I don't like my house cluttered up with rotten vegetables.
Look, Ma, I gotta hurry. Can I bring you anything?
Oh, yeah. Bring me the evening news. They're running a self-diagnosis contest. The winner gets to go to Mayo Clinic.
Bye, Ma.
Bye, son. I'll see you the rosy edge of dawn. Drink to me, oh, beware thine eyes, and I will...
Hey, put this on my bill.
Well, here it is, everybody. What do you think of it?
Well, it sure is different.
It looks delicious, but don't you think it's kind of stale?
Well, it hasn't been feeling too well.
You call that a fancy plant? It looks like it never spent an LT day in its entire life.
I don't care. I like it anyway.
You like even skunk cabbage.
Yeah. What kind of a plant is this, Seymour?
Well, I'm not sure. I got the seeds from a Japanese gardener over on Central Avenue. He found them in with an order he got from a plantation next to a cranberry farm.
Fine. You don't even know what is this plant you're growing.
Well, I gave it a name.
What name?
Oh, gee.
What? You gave it a dirty name? You can't even mention it?
Well, I named it Audrey Jr.
You named it after me? Oh, really? That's the most exciting thing anyone's ever done to me.
You poor kid.
I don't think it's so much I should keep on spending $10 a week on your salary.
But, Gravis, he named it after me.
I know, and if they keep it, they'll name it Mushnick's Folly because I'll be in jail for non-payment of taxes.
Are you crazy?
Who?
You. That's probably the only plant of its kind in the world. Don't you realize if Seymour can nurse that thing back to health, you'll have people coming here from all over?
You think so, you found
it? I know so, you Mushnick. Now, that's all I'm saying on the subject. Besides, I've got to get home. My wife's making gardenias for dinner.
Good night, you Faust.
Good night. And I'll see you tomorrow. Crazy about kosher flowers.
He's a nice man. Maybe he knows what he's talking about. Maybe he's not so stupid. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll keep you and this dumbbell junior for a week. If you can nice it back to health, you both can stay. If you can't, you're both fired.
Oh, gee, thank you, Mr. Mushnick.
Don't feel sad, Seymour.
Don't waste your pity on me, Audrey. I'm not worth it.
Who says you're not?
Everybody.
Yeah, I know. But I think you're a fine figurative of a man, and I know that Audrey Jr. will be the sweetest thing in the whole wide world.
Well, I don't know. I've given it every kind of fancy fertilizer and atomic plant food and distilled mineral water you can buy, but it just gets sicker and sicker.
Don't worry. You're going to be another Luther Glendale.
Pasadena.
Burbank. Good night, Seymour.
Night, Audrey. What's the matter, little plant? Haven't I done everything I could for you? Where did I goof? You're the first little plant I ever tried to grow, and if you die, I don't know what I'll do. Please don't die. I'll get you some water, okay? Opened up just like you do every night at sunset. I wish I knew how to make you grow. Here, let me move this out of your way so you can breathe. Ow! Ow, 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 ow! Hey, what happened? How come you woke up? Blood? You like blood? Oh, you must be kidding.
Well, we'll see.
What I'm doing for you.
Ow!
Oh, who would have thought it? Well, I guess there's just no accounting for people's tastes.
Audrey, isn't he beautiful? Isn't he delicious? Isn't he got a $2 raise? What happened to your fingers?
Bee stings. So how come I'm all of a sudden so wonderful?
5 bees, one from each finger?
10 bees. Did you say I was getting a $2 raise?
Correct, my very excellent Seymour. 10 bees.
What did I do now?
Don't you know what you did? Just look.
Oh, boy, look at that. It grew. It's almost a foot long.
Isn't it empirical?
It grows like a cold sore from the lip.
Oh, hello, young pretty ladies. What can Gravis Mushnick do for you?
Well, we saw your sign outside.
About the Audrey Jr.
So we thought we'd come in and take a look.
Well, give a look.
That makes 4 people today who've come in just to look at it.
Oh, did Shirley?
Is that just too much?
Oh, what kind of plant is it?
It's an Audrey Jr.
Where was it you got in trouble with 10 bees?
Well, is that all? I mean, doesn't it have a scientific name?
Yes, of course, but who could denounce it? You would like maybe to buy something.
Well, we don't have any money, except $2,000. But that's just to spend on flowers.
So we don't have any of our own.
Isn't that a drag?
You got just $2,000 just for to spend on flowers?
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Who died? The Chamber of Commerce?
Well, we're from Cucamonga High School.
And we're building a float for the Rose Bowl Parade. Which is made out of flowers.
Thousands of them.
And we're on the committee
that picks the florist
and then glues on the flowers.
Gee, that sure is a mad plant.
Wow, yeah.
Seymour here invented it.
He did.
Thousands of plants. Girls, please don't damage the horticulture. Tell me, how come you don't buy all these thousands of flowers from Gravis Mushnik? My flowers got something the others don't.
What's that?
They're cheap.
Well, gee, if your shop is good enough to develop the Audrey Jr.,
I guess it can get us everything we need.
Yeah, we'll talk it over with the rest of the committee.
Excellent.
Well, we gotta run now. Bye, all.
Bye, Flower.
Bye. Bye, girls. A son. Look, Audrey, I got a son.
Oh, gee, Mr. Mushnik.
What, Mr. Mushnik? I don't want you should call me Mr. Mushnik anymore. I want you should call me Dad.
Okay, Dad.
Isn't that beautiful?
Seymour Krelboin, come over here, my son. I want to talk on you about the future. Look on this fly trap. Look on it. Soon we got no more skid row. We will be rich, us. I am building for you a giant greenhouse in which you are making impossible flowers, which in turn I am selling at ridiculous prices in my giant new flower saloon in Beverly Hills. Do you see that big sign in the sky? It is saying Gravis Mushnik in French.
Isn't it exciting? And we'll have an orchestra right by the cash register. And Gravis will wave his arms. And the orchestra will play Mendelssohn's Spring Song. And I'll come out in a gown wrapped by somebody expensive and say,
the carnations are $600 a dozen, 2 dozen for 1,000.
It's a bargain.
Get it while they last.
Stop shouting. My Uncle Moshe's brother Yankel just passed away in Tenafly, New Jersey. Tell me, how much are the carnations today?
The carnations are $600 a dozen.
And why are they letting him run around loose?
Please excuse my son, Mrs. Shiver. Just point to anything in the store and it is yours.
I mean,
that's right.
The cash register, maybe, huh?
Wait a minute. Here are several dozen carnations on the house, courtesy of Gravis Mushnik, the Bloom Tycoon.
That's my dad.
Thanks. Thanks very much. Only tell me, why are you so happy? Not only did my Uncle Moshe's brother and Yankel die, Tenafly, New Jersey. You should also give some flowers to that poor dead plant there. Good morning, Mr. Mushnik. Good morning.
Good morning, Mrs. Shiver.
Look what happened to my plant, Dad.
Who are you calling Dad? Who?
Oh, no. And it was so beautiful just a few seconds ago.
Excellent. Just a few seconds ago, I gave away dozens of carnations free to Mrs. Shiver.
I didn't mean it.
You have perhaps an explanation.
No, but if you give me a minute, I'll think of one.
I can see it all now. We are in the poorhouse. That big sign in the sky, it is reading, Seymour Krelboin, rest in peace. In Arabic!
Oh, you've got to give him another chance.
You promised me a week, Mr. Mushnik. I'll sit up all night with that plant. It'll be healthy in the morning. You'll see. I promise.
Eat me. Feed me.
You said that.
Feed me.
You said that. You can talk.
I got a talking plant. Say it again.
Feed me.
Oh, boy. I never been to college and I ain't been around much. But I'd have been willing to bet there ain't no such thing as a talking plant. But I'll take your word for it. Gee, Junior, I'd like to feed you. But I used up all my fingers. Look at me, I'm all cut to pieces. But maybe I can find another drop here someplace. That's the best I can do.
More.
But I'm already anemic.
Feed me more.
Gee, Junior. I'd be happy to give you anything I got, But I gotta keep a little blood for myself or I'll be in worse shape than Mom. I'm sorry, Junior. Oh, I'll go for a walk. Maybe I'll think of something. Chowhound. Don't bother me. I got problems of my own.
Feed me.
I'm sorry, pal. I'm fresh out of blood. Talk to somebody else.
I'm hungry.
I don't care what you are. Can't you see I'm knocked out? I just killed a man. I'm a murderer. You think it's fun to be a murderer? You think it's fun to haul around a sack full of
food?
Oh, no, Junior. What kind of guy do you think I am?
I'm starved.
Maybe just a snack.
That looks great.
Now that is what I call a salad. What do you call that salad?
Caesarian.
Well, before the next course, I think I'll have a nice cigar. All right? You would like maybe a cigar?
You don't smoke cigars. What am I thinking about? Where are the matches?
Oh, you know what I found?
What?
I'm looking for the matches, and I found I left the money in the other suit.
Here's your mock chicken legs.
You don't have any money? So what else is new?
All right, all right. I made a mistake. After all, a man is entitled.
Go on, this is your story. I'll wait for the punch.
Don't get smart with me, girlie. I'll have you know that in my shop in the cash register, I'm having the total day's receipts, which is summing up to more than $9. You'll bring the rest of the food, then I'll go to the shop and get the money.
You're playing my favorite song. Now look here, Buster. One of you is going to go down right now and get the loot, while the other one stays here until the first one gets back, if you get what I mean.
Oh, fine. In this fancy schmancy restaurant, you are holding hostages, right?
All right.
Excellent. You eat up, Audrey. I'll be back in a flash with the cash.
Bye, Gravis.
To be jolly, la 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 la. It's the season to be jolly, la 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 la. It's the season to be jolly, la 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 la.
You flush now, right?
Bring me whiskey, rum, wine, gin, bourbon.
What?
Scotch, rye, tequila, sake, manischewitz.
Did you bring the money?
Don't bug me with the money. I got to get drunk now.
What flipped him?
I don't know.
Look here. Here, take it. Bring me anything. Bring me everything. Creme de mint. Everything you got.
Okay.
Grab it. What happened?
Don't ask.
You look like you've seen a ghost.
Ghosts I could handle. Don't ask.
Why don't you tell me? Maybe I could help you.
Help you couldn't.
Try and eat something. It'll calm your aggravation.
In mine own shop. Audrey, you wouldn't believe it.
I wish you'd break out and tell me.
All right, I'll tell you tomorrow, right after I am telling the police.
But Mushnick didn't come to the police. If he had, that might have been the finish of the unhappy story. It was not.
You wouldn't be interested in selling a half interest to this place, huh?
Mr. Mushnick,
we talked to the committee,
and they said we could use your flower
on the float.
And guess what?
We're going to feature Audrey Jr.
Right on top.
Boy,
can't you just picture it?
I can picture
it. Oh, won't the people just eat it up?
Eat up the people.
And we're going to have the big part of it open so she can sit in it.
Oh.
The queen with her crown and scepter. She'll be so cute. Oh, you could just eat her up.
Eat up the girl.
Oh, there's Seymour!
Oh, my jaw, I got a toothache. It hurts. Oh, let go of my jaw.
Now, Seymour, talk on me.
I got a toothache. What do you want to talk about?
That plant. Is that a nice subject for to talk?
The plant is great. It's four times bigger than it was yesterday.
I saw. How come the plant is now so big?
Oh, I don't know. But look at all them people out there. We only been open a half hour, and we already done $70 worth of business.
85. Now, look, Seymour. You gave this plant a fancy name, Audrey Jr., but I want to know right now, what do just people call it?
Well, it's a cross between a butterworth and a Venus flytrap.
Venus flytrap? And what are the habits of this Venus flytrap?
Well, the book says it eats insects. It eats them three times in its life, and then it's full grown.
Excellent.
And how many times is this one eat?
Well, once or twice.
You don't remember?
Well, this is kind of an unusual type fly trap.
That is a possibility.
It may never eat again. I don't see how it could get any bigger.
Then you think it don't need any more flies?
Yeah. Oh, my tooth is just killing me.
All right, excellent. You run along to the dentist. I'll take care of things here.
Thanks, boss.
Gravis, we've got to order more flowers. Tons of them.
I'm making lots of money.
When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did, like shooting puppies with a BB gun. I'd poison guppies, and when I was done, I'd find a pussycat bash.
When I was young and just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things that I did, like placing Legos in my parents' path. They would step on them and I would laugh.
That's when my mama said,
what did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tendencies pay.
I'd find a Barbie doll and bash its head. That's when my mama said,
what did she say?
She said, my child, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tendencies pay.
You'll be a dentist. You have a talent for causing things.
Hey, hey.
Some be a dentist. People will pay you to be inhumane. Your temperament's wrong for the priesthood, and teaching would suit you still.
And all hygienists, you have a talent for causing things pain.
Hey,
dental hygienists, people will pay you to be inhumane.
Humane.
Your temperament's wrong for the daycare, and teaching would suit you still less.
Some be a dentist, you'll be a success.
Use dental hygiene, you'll be a success.
Oh, that hurts! Wait, I'm not numb!
Shut up. Open wide. Here I come!
Here they come, folks, the leaders of the plat. Watch them pry off that cap. Oh, my God!
Why is a cabochon? Painless is no fun.
Who wants their tinkling by Cruella DeVille?
Oh, that hurts. Wait, I'm not numb!
Shut up. Open wide. Here I come.
I'm a hygienist.
I'm a dentist and a fixer. Say ah.
Ah.
Say ah. Say ah.
Okay.
I'm a hygienist and I get off on the pain I inflict.
Really love it.
I smirk when I hurt your dry socket.
I'm your dentist. I enjoy the career that I pick. I'm your dentist. And I get off on the pain I inflict. I thrill when I drill a bicuspid.
I crow when I crow a periodontal pocket. And though it may cause my patients distress, so
somewhere in heaven above me. I know that my mama's proud of me.
Oh, mama.
'Cause I'm a hygienist and a success. Say ah.
Ah.
Say ah.
Ah.
Say ah. Now spit!
Please, I don't want to be anymore.
That'll teach you to keep your bill up to date. Go ahead and run, you sniveling dog. Go ahead and run. I'm glad I heard you. I'm glad.
Seymour, I got a bad tooth, huh?
No, I thought this was the men's room.
Seymour, come back here, you bad dog. You get in there. So, you are the young man who ruined my gladiolas, huh? Sit down.
Come on.
Guess what?
My tooth stopped hurting. Yes, I know. Let's see. Shut up and open up. Uh-huh.
Ah. Uh-huh.
Does that hurt?
Yeah.
Good, you haven't felt anything yet. Uh-huh.
It's just over here.
Seymour, who was the dentist here, you or me? I'll find that tooth. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Look at that stalagmite. But don't worry, it's going to be an easy one, Seymour. I won't even use Novocaine.
Oh, you broke the mirror in my mouth.
Well, don't tell me about it, stupid. Just swallow it. All right, yes. Let's see now, Seymour. Let's see, I'll have this one and this one and that one, and I have to have this one, Seymour.
It's only one tooth.
Seymour, who is the dentist here, you or me? Are you practicing dentistry without a license?
No.
All right. Uh-huh. Let's see. Seymour, don't be nervous. Look at that.
Will you look at that, Seymour?
I didn't know you were an elk. You know, I can't afford an assistant. So I get this ready instant mix. It doesn't last very long, but it tastes good. Mm. All right, Seymour.
Oh, stay away from me.
Seymour.
You're trying to kill me.
A duel. Aha. Who?
Here's Johnny.
Is this Stoddard's office?
Just a minute.
Oh, yes. I see it is. You can come in now. My name is Wilberforce.
Wilberforce what?
Just Wilberforce. My first name is Wilbur. My last name is Force. I don't have a middle name.
Well, you have an appointment, maybe?
No, but you were very highly recommended to me by one of your patients, a Mrs. Eshiva. I do a lot of undertaking for her relatives.
Well, as you can see, I have a customer now, and I'm all booked up for the rest of the day, so you'll have to come back tomorrow.
Oh, I couldn't do that. I have 3 or 4 abscesses, a touch of pyorrhea, 9 or 10 cavities. I lost my pivot tooth, and I'm in terrible pain.
Well, I can't help you today.
Oh, that's all right. I'll just wait outside. The patient came to me with a large hole in his abdomen caused by a fire poker used on him by his wife. He almost bled to death and gangrene had set in. I didn't give him much of a chance. There were other complications. The man had cancer, tuberculosis, leprosy, and a touch of the grip. I decided to operate.
My patient just left. You could come in now.
Oh, goody. I didn't see the other man leave.
Well,
He went out the back door.
You know, most people don't like to go to the dentist, but I rather enjoy it myself, don't you? I mean, there's a real feeling of growth, of progress when that old drill goes in. I mean, I'd almost rather go to the dentist than anywhere, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Now, no Novocaine. It dulls the senses.
This is gonna hurt you more than it is me.
Oh, goody, goody, here it comes. Oh, my God, don't stop now!
Well, I made a lot of holes, and now I gotta fill it up with this here silver stuff.
Well, aren't you gonna pull any?
Well,
Oh, go on.
Well, it's your mouth.
Well, Dr. Favre, it's been quite an afternoon. I can truly say I've never enjoyed myself so much. I'll recommend you to all my friends.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye now.
Feed me.
Oh, take it easy, Dracula. What do you think I'm carrying here, my dirty laundry? Should be enough for anybody.
Good.
Well, goodbye, Dr. Farr. You may have been a crummy dentist, but you were a nice fella. I never meant to kill anybody in my whole life. I've killed two in the last 2 days. Well, but you asked for it, coming after me with that knife and all. Fun voyage, Dr. Farr. You want anything else? See you in the morning.
Come in.
It's me, Joe.
Come on in, Frank. How's the wife, Frank?
Not bad, Joe.
Glad to hear it. The kids?
Lost one yesterday.
Lost one, eh? How'd that happen?
Playing with matches.
Well, those are bricks.
Yeah, I guess so.
Got a strange one here. Railroad people say they lost one of their best detectives the other night.
Oh, yeah?
Down by the yards. He's watching the refrigerator cars.
Refrigerator cars?
Ice thieves.
Oh, yeah? What happened?
Don't know. Vanished. Blood on tracks.
Clues?
None.
Anything else?
Dennis. Farb.
Dead?
Missing.
Clues?
Blood in office.
Where?
Skid Row.
Ideas?
None.
Check it out?
Yeah.
Now we are on the case. Officer Frank Stooley and me. My name is Fink. Sergeant Joe Fink. I'm a Fink.
Something?
It's monstrositous.
Yeah.
And to think that you did it.
Gee, Audrey, you don't have to kiss me.
Don't you like me to kiss you?
Yeah, but you don't like to kiss me.
Why shouldn't I?
Nobody else ever did.
Well, I do like to.
You do? You really do? You like to kiss me?
Sure I do.
Would you like to kiss me again?
Okay.
That plant?
Oh, boy, you kiss good, Audrey.
Oh, I guess I just have a good kisser.
How did it?
Would you like to go out on a date with me some night?
When?
Oh, sure I would, Seymour. Anytime.
Tonight?
Okay.
Oh, boy.
About that plant.
We got the list of flowers for the float, for the rose parade.
I can't talk to you now, girls. Talk on Audrey.
We got the list for the float.
Okay, let's take a look at it.
Okay.
Hi, what's cooking?
Look at my plant.
My, what a large one.
Yeah. Hello, Mr. Shiva. What's new?
Oh, I got terrible news. Manaki Frankie just lost his little boy.
Oh, that's too bad. How'd it happen?
He was playing with matches.
Would you like to buy maybe some flowers?
About 50 cents worth.
Well, I'll get them for you. Look at my plant.
I'm looking.
Your name, Gravis Mushnik?
Mushnik Gravis, that's my name.
Just want to ask you a few questions.
Questions, ask me.
Just want to ask you a few questions.
I didn't do it.
Do what?
Whatever.
Ever see this man?
Man, see picture.
Why are you so nervous?
You got a guilty conscience?
No, why should I?
Ever see this man?
Man, see the picture, Dr. Farb.
So you know him?
My dentist. He maybe did something.
Disappeared.
Blood in his office.
The other man, too. Blood in the railroad tracks.
A few spare parts.
Dr. Farb is murdered.
Is he?
No, who knows? Not me.
What do you think?
He doesn't know anything.
Okay, Mushnik. If you hear anything about these men, call our office.
Sure, I'll be glad to cooperate with the police.
Hello, Aunt Sitting.
Oh, isn't it terrible what happened to your boy, Frankie?
Those are the brakes.
All right, Seymour. Now you tell me if that plant is finished all grown up.
He's finished all growing up.
You wouldn't kid your father.
My father came home?
Me, idiot! It's a finger of speech. Now look. I can't stand any more that plant. It's growing me out of house and home.
Well, it ain't gonna grow anymore, I promise.
How can you be so sure?
It ate three times already.
What did it eat this time?
Well, about a million Japanese beetles.
So don't eat no more.
It's full.
Gravis! There's a lady from some kind of a commitment outside. I think it's important.
Excellent. By the by, I understand you want to take Audrey out on a date tonight. That's very good with me, because I am staying to keep an eye on that Meshuggah plant.
Where are we going to go tonight, Seymour?
Well, I just remembered I don't have any money.
Well, that's okay. We could take a walk along the ocean or something.
I got a great idea. We can eat dinner at my house. My mom's a great cook.
Well, that's swell.
Oh, boy, I'll call her later and tell her.
Okay.
Oh, that's remarkable.
You like?
Oh, I neither like nor dislike anything, my goodness. I happen to represent the Society of Silent Flower Observers of Southern California.
How about that?
Tell me, who created this magnificent bloom?
I did, me.
And what might your name be?
Seymour Krelboyne with a K.
Krelboyne.
Krelboyne.
Raised it in a coffee can.
This? Tell me, Mr. Krelboyne, is this a freak or can more be raised from the seeds?
We should live so long.
Well, I don't think there are going to be any more, Miss...
Fishtwanger. Mrs. Hortense Fishtwanger.
I think this is going to be the only one, Mrs. Fishtwanger.
Fishtwanger.
Fishtwanger?
It's probably indigestible anyway.
At any rate, I have the honor to tell you, Seymour Krelboyne, that you have been selected to receive the annual trophy of the Society of Silent Flower Observers of Southern California.
A trophy? Me?
Such is justice.
Tell me, when do you suppose those large buds will open?
Well, according to what the book says about the plants that I crossed, they should open day after tomorrow at sunset.
Ah, very well. Then I shall return at that time to present the trophy. Good day. Remarkable.
gonna get a trophy.
Oh, Seymour, I'm so proud of you.
Oh, a real trophy
for Andre Jr.
We can put it on the float.
In the Rose Parade.
Oh, boy.
Don't look at me. I'm a terrible sight. I'm a complete sea hag.
She always says that.
Oh, well, it's true. I haven't been feeling very well lately.
Audrey, this is my ma, Winifred Krellboing. Ma, this is Audrey Fulquart. She's my girl.
Hi, Audrey. Are you hungry?
I sure am. I could eat a hearse.
Oh, well, sit right down, and I'll go get the first course.
Sit here, Audrey. You want me to take your sweater?
Never mind that. Well, now try this.
It tastes like cough syrup.
Dr. Flynn's cough syrup. A toast?
To Audrey Jr.
No, to Audrey Sr.
I keep an eye on you. I don't let nobody get near you.
Here comes the soup. Now, don't touch it till I get the flavoring.
Gee, Audrey, you sure look good by candlelight.
Oh, do I really, Seymour?
Yeah.
Here you are. I'll try it.
Sure smells different.
It's different.
Some kind of oil, isn't it?
Cod liver oil. It's wonderful for the colon.
And that sulfur powder on the top.
Other fine kettlefin fish. Who would you like to have tonight?
You look fat enough.
We not only got a talking plant, we got one that makes with smart cracks. Will you listen to me, you botanical bum? Food you wouldn't get. Not from Gravis Mushnik.
I'm starved.
Excellent. You would unpopulate all Skid Row. Well, you can forget about it. You wouldn't get fed from Gravis Mushnik tonight. Good night.
You'll get yours.
I kind of like this chow mein.
If it tastes a little bitter, it's because it's made of Chinese herbs and it's flavored with acromycin and Epsom salts.
There ain't another cook in the whole world like my ma.
That's what your old man said before the louse ran out on me. You know, if you're gonna be married, you gotta be a good cook.
Well, maybe you could teach me.
You think me getting married?
Well, he hasn't asked me yet.
Who hasn't?
Seymour.
Seymour's too young to get married. Look here, a boy's gotta go out and play around a little bit. Go out on the make and have a ball.
Seymour, I don't wanna have a ball. I wanna be with Audrey.
Look, Seymour. You promised you wouldn't get married until you bought me an iron lung.
You've been breathing for years, Ma.
Well, it ain't easy. It ain't easy, son.
Hello? Nobody here. Black hat, 13th John Friday, the 13th is stupid superstition.
All right, you. Come out of there.
Don't shoot, mister. I'm old and sick. I wouldn't know even a fly.
Come out in the light where I can see you.
Come on. Please don't shoot. Please. Please, I'm on the gravis, Mushnik. You wouldn't want to kill me. Where would you hide the body?
Don't worry, I'm not going to shoot you. Not unless you try something.
Try something? I never tried anything in my life. I wouldn't try anything now. You want my money? Take it.
You want I should go out and steal you some more? That's all right, too. I'll do it. Thank you very much. I like your brand of hospitality.
You'll excuse it isn't more. I'm only a poor florist.
Yeah, yeah. I got about 30 bucks here. Come on now. Where's the rest of it? I was in here this afternoon. I saw about 30,000 people in here. They must have spent some money. Where is it?
There ain't no more money. They came in to look on the plant. It's a big attraction. Audrey Jr.
The plant. Don't try to snow me, Jim. 30,000 squares didn't come in here just to look for a plant. I want it.
I don't got no more money, honest. Believe me.
Okay, let's try this. One, two, three, four.
No, I ain't got no more money, honest.
All right, try it the other way around. Five, four, three, two...
All right, already.
Okay, Big Bad, where?
In the plant.
In the plant.
The big plant, Audrey Jr.
Inside the big leaf.
That's right, inside.
How do you get it open?
Just knock.
In there? In there?
Inside, in the bottom.
I don't see anything.
Way inside. Right in the bottom. You got it, a date with Audrey tonight. I am no more sitting up with that no good Nick plant.
But gee, Mr. Mushnick, you don't have to sit up with it anymore. It's all grown up now.
Excellent, smart guy. How do you know it don't be hungry no more?
Well, because...
Tonight you are staying. Then tomorrow they're coming and they're going to give you a trophy. And then after that we are getting rid once and for all for that plant.
Getting rid of it? Why?
Don't ask why. Why? The end. Into the garbage can. Aloha. Oy. Yes, Mrs. Shiva.
Oh, Seymour, you wonderful plant.
Oh, that's all right, Audrey. I'll grow other plants, even more wonderful ones.
I know you will. Did you figure out what we're doing tonight?
Yeah, we're going to a place full of beautiful flowers.
We have to stay here.
Yeah.
Well, never mind. We'll have a picnic. It'll be just like going to the country.
Oh,
did you
boy.
Get the 3,000 pink azaleas?
For the arbor.
And the 9,000 yellow moms?
For the border.
Yeah,
and the roses
yeah,
for the front and the back?
No, around the back.
What do you mean you're going to a picnic at night with that full cord girl?
Don't you like Audrey, Ma?
She's out after your money.
I don't have any money.
Oh, she's a smart one. She'll latch on to you until you get some, and then goodbye fortune.
But Audrey's an honest girl, Ma.
Yeah, never trust a woman who's too healthy.
But Audrey had a bad cold a couple of weeks ago.
Oh, a cold, a puny cold. Why don't you get yourself a real female with something decent like mononucleosis or gallstones?
Well, maybe she could catch something like that.
The only thing she'll catch is you.
And she'll take you off to some shady sanitarium and leave me to chiropractors and faith healers. I know when I'm not wanted.
Oh! Oh, gee, Ma.
Don't feel sorry for me. I'll just find a nice wet alley somewhere and curl up and wait for the end.
Oh, please don't die till I get back, will you, Ma? I'll take care of you. I'll always take care of you. I promise.
Yeah.
Bye. Gee, Audrey, I never tasted food like this before.
The peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
peanut butter and jelly, what does that cure?
Nothing. It's just a food.
Well, what good is it if it doesn't clear up pimples or shrink your sinus tissues or something?
You're just being silly, Seymour. Seymour, what do you want to be?
Well, I want to grow things. If I had a lot of money, I'd go to the South Seas where they grow the most fabulous plants in the world.
Well, that sounds exciting.
Yeah.
I'd like to go to the South Seas, too.
There's no reason why you couldn't go.
Would you take me with you, Seymour?
Oh, I couldn't very well go without you, Audrey.
Why not?
Well, because I'm in love with you, Audrey.
Oh, I'm in love with you, too, Seymour.
Feed me.
What'd you say?
I was just kidding.
I'm hungry.
Seymour.
I didn't mean it.
Why did you say it?
Oh, food.
You didn't even say that.
Oh, yes, I did. I said it.
Oh, I'm looking right at you.
I'm a ventriloquist.
You're what?
A ventriloquist.
Feed me.
Seymour, do you feel all right?
Well, I don't know. I'm not sure.
Well, then stop all this nonsense and kiss me.
I'm dying from hunger.
All right, if you're so hungry, eat something, but forget about me.
Gee, I'm sorry, Audrey.
Give me to eat.
If you can't control yourself, I'm going home.
I need some chow.
Oh.
Ugh, an empty stomach.
Audrey, please wait. Listen to me.
I've listened to all the nonsense I want to hear, Seymour. You're a nut. You tell me that you love me, and then you act like a complete idiot.
Please listen, Audrey. I'll be able to explain everything soon.
Well, why can't you explain now?
Because so many things are so important. I want to marry you, but I got to take care of Mom. Well, that plant in there is going to make it all come true. Tomorrow they're going to give me a trophy, and I'll be famous. I'll be a big botanist. And then we can go to the South Seas, just like we planned and all.
But that doesn't have anything to do with what went on in there. When you're ready to come to your senses, Seymour, then I'll talk to you. Good night, Seymour.
I'm getting pretty tired of you.
I need food.
I don't care what you need. Look what you've done to me. You not only made a butcher out of me, but you drove my girl away.
Shut up and bring on the food.
Don't tell me to shut up. You shut up. Who raised you from a bunch of little seeds? Who fed you all them high-class fertilizers and sat up all night with you when you were sick? Nobody else would have done that for you. Do you think anybody else would have brought you human beings to eat? You're darn right they wouldn't. Well, I've helped you, and you've helped me. Now shut your trap and go to sleep. I'm tired.
Crowbine! Tara! Close your eyes. You are asleep. Open your eyes. Now you will do as I say. Do you follow me?
Yes, Master.
You will go out and find me some food.
Yes, Master.
Now be gone, and waste no time.
My name is Leonora Clyde. How's the rain on the rhubarb?
Master is hungry.
Well, hello there.
Master. I gotta find food for Master. Food I gotta find for Master. For Master, I gotta find food.
Maybe I can help.
Who are you?
My name is Leonora Clyde. I love you.
Master wants food.
Let the old goat wait. The night is young, and so are we.
Master doesn't eat goat.
Well, what kind of food does he like?
Ooh!
That's more like it. Kiss me. What's the matter? Don't you like me?
Too bony.
Too bony? Nobody ever told me that before.
Beef is better than veal.
You're such a dodo. What do you call this? Chopped liver?
Master would like more fat.
Speak for yourself, John.
My name is Seymour.
My name is Seymour.
That's my name, too.
Are you interested, or are you just wasting my time?
I never thought anybody would volunteer. Do you volunteer?
Sure, I do.
All right, if you're sure you want to volunteer.
All right, my place or yours?
I don't care.
Well, flip a coin.
I don't have a coin.
Flip anything, silly.
Well, there's a rock. Wet or dry?
Wet.
Search was narrowing, and we knew that soon we would have the killer. Not that we had any more clues than before, but we had to tell the chief something. I had that feeling in my bones that the mystery was drawing to its climax, and I was determined to be on hand.
All right, out, out, out. Nobody is in. Today we have a special occasion for Seymour Crowboyne, which has invented the big plan. So I want everybody should please stay out of the way.
We want Seymour! We want Seymour! We want Seymour! Seymour!
I tell you, this business is worse than being a conductor in a revoluting door. I'll be glad when this day is finished.
What's a celebration?
They're presenting my son with a trophy.
Yeah, what'd he do, run away from home?
Please don't look at me that way, Audrey. I want to talk to you.
I'm sorry, Seymour. I just don't understand you.
I'll explain everything after the ceremony.
Yo, police, what are you doing here?
Heard there was something going on here this evening.
Just thought we'd come by and keep an eye on things.
Look, we don't need no eyes kept on nothing.
Wait, the Society of Silent Flower Observers has arrived, and sunset is almost upon us.
Welcome, lady and gentlemen. We are honored for to have you.
Still working on those disappearances.
We think they were murdered.
Hey, look here, young man. That's no way to talk at a time like this. Let me see your tongue. Now, what you got?
Just the facts, ma'am.
Trench mouth. I know, I had it back in '09.
Better have that looked into, Frank.
Whatever you say, Joe.
Mr. Crowboy, the sun is going down now, and you do think those buds are going to open?
I hope so.
Because if they don't, Mr. Crowboy, we shall just have to present the award at another time.
Oh, it's starting to open!
This is a mark. That is open.
Isn't that the
railroad cop? Look at the rest. What do you think, Frank?
They're all there, Joe.
Yes, you're right. Mr. Crowboyne, how do you explain this?
I didn't mean it.
That's right, officer. He didn't mean to kill them.
Seymour!
Seymour,
you promised you'd explain.
Looks like they're getting away, Joe.
Yes, you're right. Let's catch them.
Right.
Oh, now the float will be perfect.
Yeah.
Thank you. You wouldn't find him here with the toilets. Let's go back.
Dirty rat plant, you messed up my whole life!
Feed me!
I'll feed you. I'll feed you like you've never been fed before.
You think you can hurt me?
It seems like the evil is going to win, destroying everything, leading open to conquer the world. Can anybody save the planet Earth? Is it possible? Can anyone stop this creature? Is it possible that in this small little building that there could be some semblance to save mankind? Close the window. Well, once again, the creature was defeated. But did our hero survive? Did our hero survive? Well, wait a minute. What do I see? It's a happy ending for Seymour and Audrey. They find all their dreams come true. But can it happen again? Can it all happen again? We must beware and be on guard.
She believes she knows that creepy things will be happening.
Although these events are not likely with GMOs, they are possible.
Look at food packaging. Remember how overnight everything came without gluten? In fact, it was prominently displayed, without gluten, gluten-free. Why? Well, celiac, of course, but it caught on. Read food labels today. Go to health food stores and read how prominently displayed, no GMOs. What are they? What's the big deal? Are they hazards to your health? And what about those food wars? Keep your eye on a documentary called Farmageddon. Look at the war against raw milk, lawsuits over seed washers, watch the documentary Food Incorporated, and what's all this talk about Monsanto? You're thinking, where have I been? Go ahead, jump into this subject. It's fine. Feet first. Start Googling. It will fascinate you. And where's the media been? Where do you think? Comment!
There's truly a GMO time bomb that some genetically modified organism will have an effect and create a virus that could create an irritation of the blood fever and produce incredible problems for humanity.
Darkness falls across the land. The midnight hour is close at hand. Creatures crawl in search of blood to terrorize your neighborhood.
And whosoever shall be found without the soul for getting down must stand and face the hounds of hell and rot inside a corpse's shell.
The foulest stench is in the air, the funk of 40,000 years, and grizzled ghouls from every tomb are closing in to seal your doom.
The demons squeal in sheer delight. It's you they spy, so plump, so right. For though the groove is hard to beat, yet still you stand with frozen feet. You try to run, you try to scream, but no more sun you'll ever see.
You fight to stay alive, your body starts to shiver, for no mere mortal can resist the evil of the thriller.
And yes, it is indeed possible that there could be a genetically modified time bomb. Time's running out, and any politician, scientist, or anybody who tells you that GMO products are safe is either very, very, very stupid or lying to cover up profit motive.
Here comes my happiness again, right back to where it should have been. Cause now she's gone and I'm free. She can't do a thing to me. I just want to dance the night away with senoritas who can sway. Right now, tomorrow's looking bright, just like the sunny morning light. And if you should see her, let her know that I'm yours, you know. And if you see her, I'll tell you. Just just wanna dance in my world. We're singing leaders who can swing. Right now, tomorrow's looking bright. Just let the sun in one light. Little known that I